Parliament passed the National Insurance Scheme Bill in March 2021, but President Yoweri Museveni declined to assent it due to disagreements among some stakeholders. Since then, the government has remained mute on the matter. During their meeting on social protection today, MPs were rallied by experts to push for enactment of the National Health Insurance Law as a way to protect themselves from financing medical bills of their constituents directly from their pockets.
Context. One of the key costs that affect a person is the cost for medical care. And simply because people cannot afford, people run to relatives and politicians to seek for support. And in fact, if we cannot have a health insurance scheme, then our health insurance scheme shall be politicians.
I mean, as members of parliament and also for us who work in Kampala, you do not finish 3 months without getting a call from the village asking that can we contribute money for health care of people. We believe that those people already contribute. You've seen that high, big percentage of out-of-pocket. If we transferred that contribution from out-of-pocket into health insurance coverage, we will improve that health system.
Lawmakers acknowledge that they are overwhelmed by requests to bail out their voters who get stuck with medical bills in different health facilities.
To be honest with you, anybody sick in our constituencies is our responsibility. It would really be a blessing to handle this issue of health insurance. It needs Committee of Health to come up with proper strategies.
You know, health insurance actually is a social protection matter. And my view is that we need to think that Minister of Gender should be the one championing this. Because this has been there for a very long time with the Minister of Health, and they have not been able to make progress.
The insurance scheme intends to provide health care for all Ugandans at an affordable cost, but Ugandans, both in formal and informal sectors, make a financial contribution. The bill was providing that those employed in formal sector contribute 4% of their salaries, backed by a 1% contribution from their employers, and those in informal sector contribute 100,000 shillings annually. Experts believe this is achievable, provided the government resolves the impending issues.
Private sector thinks that having this law, or the bill in which it was presented last time, was a threat to their investments, because they will be required to pay a lot of money, which then increases the cost of doing business in Uganda. But I think there has to be a middle ground, and the investors also need to appreciate that they actually pay these bills all the time. Most of them run health insurance schemes.
However, legislators are still divided, as some are opposed to the health insurance scheme while others are green about it.
National insurance, is it the health insurance? Dear friends, I want to get us very clear that to me, I don't buy that idea of the national health insurance, because this is just putting the money into the hands of the private sector and killing the government harm.
In Zambia, the national health insurance is working very well. We are together with Susan there. There's a lot of write-up. We don't have to reinvent the wheel.
The Parliamentary Forum on Social Protection has advised for community insurance as an alternative measure that can mitigate gaps in the sector before the robust insurance is put in place.
The insurance schemes are good, and indeed we have quite a number that is happening. One classic example of a community health insurance scheme is the one that is run in Chisizi community area, and also another one that is running around Bwindi in Kanungu. Those provide basic examples on how the community can come together, contribute very, very small sums of money, but ultimately benefit.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.